In this video, I'm going to try and explain the basic terminologies and steps for a bilateral cleft lip repair. For a detailed description, please refer to the textbooks. This technique is again based on Millard's technique. Now, when you draw a bilateral cleft lip, this is how the diagram should look. We have the nose and the lip elements. Now, there are certain terminologies over here. The central segment is called as the prolabium. Now this consists mainly of skin and mucosa, and it is considered to be devoid of the muscular element. Below the prolabium is the bony segment, which is known as the premaxilla. The premaxilla is very important because it is considered to be the growth center. Now these are the lateral vermilion segments, which carry with them the skin, mucosa, as well as the muscle. Now the landmarks are essentially same as that for a unilateral cleft lip. You will be able to identify the center of the base of the columella, that on either side, and there will be the prolabium from where we will get our lip elements. This will be the base of the ala on either side, and just as in case of unilateral cleft lips, this will be where the vermilion begins to thin or there is maximum thickness of the white roll. Now when we start to make the filtral segments from the prolabium, we need to know about the measurement. That is, the base is usually 4 to 6 mm and the base is wider compared to the top. So if this is 4 to 6 mm, this we keep it as 2 to 3 mm. So you have to take a caliper and do the measurements. So considering this as a total of 4 mm, we take the midpoint and on either side we get points that are 2 mm away. Now, from these points till the center of the base of the columella, we have to make these converging lines, which will form the filtral column. Once you are done with this and finish the other markings, you have to begin the dissection. After you have done the dissection and you have raised this flap upwards, as shown in the second diagram, the dissection which is done is again in three layers, which is of the skin, the muscle, and the mucosa. Now in these cases, it is important to recreate the buccal sulcus here, for which you will again get the mucosa from these lateral elements. The dissection is completed, and what you will be asked primarily is from where does the columella and the filtral column come, and from where does the center of the Cupid's bow come. Now the columella and the filtral column come from this part, which is the prolabium, whereas the center of the Cupid's bow actually comes from the lateral vermilion segments. Once the first mucosal layer repair is complete, then the muscle is repaired, and then finally the skin is repaired. In complete cases, obviously, the closure will go up into the nasal floor and it will be recreated. The mucosal elements like the M and L flaps are those that are seen in case of a unilateral cleft lip repair. The final diagram that you will be see is that of the final scar. So the final scar will come from along the nasal floor, go along the filtral ridges on either side, make the center of the Cupid's bow, and it will go through over here. This will be the final scar in case of a bilateral cleft lip repair. So the important terminologies are the prolabium and these lateral segments, and it is important to know from where the columella, the filtral column, comes, and from where the Cupid's bow is formed.